I think it'll be hit, but there will still be sales. Many of the people I'm talking to have assumed that almost no homes are selling, but about half the number of sales we would expect to see at this time of the year are still selling. If you look at 2008, there were still about 4 million home sales in the bottom of the great financial crisis. And normally there's maybe five or six. So the people who are selling right now are the ones who have to sell. And that is still an essential part of the U.S. economy.
What's going on with prices?
Well, prices are mostly holding steady. So it's really a tale of two markets. Buyer demand is fairly strong. It's not as strong as it was pre-pandemic, but maybe it's down 20%, whereas listing demand is down 60% or something like that. No one who is selling a house right now is doing it because she wants to. The people who are selling today are the ones who have to, and everyone else is holding out for better times. And so inventory is down 21%, and it just limits how far prices can fall. If you look at 2008 as a comparison, I was the CEO of Redfin back then too. Inventory was piling up. And right now it's the opposite situation where nobody is selling unless she has to.
What's the biggest obstacle at the moment? Is it because people are fearful of the economic outlook, so they don't want to be spending a lot on this type of item at the moment? Or is it simply that it's impossible to do viewings? And I guess despite all the advances, people aren't likely to buy a house until they've at least seen it once.
That's true. Although what we're seeing is a massive upsurge in video chat tours. It used to be about 0.5% of our tours happened virtually, and now a third of them are happening virtually. And you have these contracts where people say, I want to agree to terms now, and I'll see the property after we agree on a price. The seller prefers that because he doesn't want strangers coming through the house, and the buyer prefers that too so that she can stay sheltered in place. The real issue, aside from the fact that nobody wants to sell, is actually credit. So the federal government has been shoveling money into the credit markets, but you're still seeing breakdowns all along the line. Nobody wants to service loans right now because they can't front the cash. There's 12 months of forbearance available very easily for a consumer, which is great for the consumer. We should definitely do that. But it means that credit standards are tightening up right when houses are getting affordable. Most people aren't loaning to anybody below 700, and they're requiring all sorts of money down. So that is something that's happening in the market, despite the government's efforts to protect the creditors.
Yeah, no, Diana Olick's been reporting on this a lot for us. So what's the solution,
so
Glenn? Do we need a bailout for the mortgage servicers? She is so good. I agree.
She is so good. She's so good. What we need is just to continue to fix all the leaks in the system. It's sort of a game of whack-a-mole where the jumbo loan market shuts down, and then we have to figure out a way to buy mortgage-backed securities in that market, and then the servicers have issues, so nobody can sell the loans in the first place, so we have to figure out a way to protect them. And it's just going to be one crisis after another, because it's hard to be confident to loan somebody money for 30 years when unemployment is at 11 or 14%.
Really quickly, Glenn, do you think that real estate in Manhattan and other dense areas is going to be permanently changed by this?
Oh, I hope not. I love New York. But we have seen that more people are interested in that house at the foot of the mountains by the lake. Rural demand is much stronger right now than urban demand. And that is a flip from where it's been for the longest time, where everybody wanted to live in the city. So we'll see how it comes back. But there seems to be a profound psychological change among the consumers who are looking for houses, both online and in person. We're seeing much more activity in the outlying areas.